Good afternoon, children. Welcome again to our online session. Hope you are fine with good health. Moving forward to make our teaching learning process enjoyable, let us begin with our new topic, Abdul becomes a courtier. Courtier means a person who attends a royal court as an advisor to the king or queen. Children, we all grown up listening and reading fascinating tales, fables, fairy tales, comics. Nowadays, you watch cartoons on TV. All are imaginary characters. All characters are fascinating, isn't it? Yes. Children, have you heard about Akbar and Birbal tales? I'm sure you're familiar with these characters. But have you heard about Mulla Do Pyaza? In the folk tales, it is depicted that Mulla Do Pyaza was a witty character, Birbal's rival in Akbar's court. Our today's chapter, adapted from the story Enter Mulla Do Pyaza, the play has been written by Pratibha Nath. Mulla Do Pyaza, his real name was Abdul Mohin. Mulla Do Pyaza was advisor of the Mughal Emperor Akbar and greatly jealous of his witty courtier Birbal. Mulla Do Pyaza, also portrayed as witty, was Birbal's rival. Even though this folk tale originated at the end of Akbar's reign, Mulla Do Pyaza began to appear. Most scholars consider him to be completely fictional. Pratibha Nath is a writer of books for children and freelance journalist. Let's begin with the lesson 2.3. Abdul becomes a courtier. Father, who is a schoolmaster, is getting ready to go to school. Abdul, father, to knowledge and erudition I aspire, to study hard and deep. Books I require. Will you lend me a little gold? Books I will buy and study to rise high in the world. Father, only the first half of the month has passed, but alas, the money doesn't last. Great books and manuscripts are so expensive, they are treasures rare and exclusive. But from my school, I will try to borrow books that will take you to a brighter tomorrow. Abdul, that will be great. How eagerly I wait. In the evening when father returns. Abdul, how many books could you get? Oh, now my life will be all set. Father, I am so sorry, son. Couldn't lay my hands on even one. Chorus, poor Abdul is sad and dejected. Ponders, why my wishes are thus rejected. Continues to do his daily chores, reads borrowed books in 10-cent scores. An idea then crosses his mind to serve the rich and get paid in kind. Abdul becomes a courtier. Courtier means a person who attends a royal court as an advisor to the king or queen. The lesson Abdul becomes a courtier is adapted from the book Enter Mulla Do Pyaza. It is written in a dialogue form by Pratibha Nath. The characters in this play are Abdul, Abdul's father, merchant, friend, emperor, minister. The play Abdul becomes a courtier starts with Abdul speaking to his father, who is a schoolmaster, getting ready to go to school. Abdul is an ambitious young boy who is aspire, means dream for knowledge, erudition means learning. He wishes to read a book and rise high in the world. So he asks his father to buy books. Father said him sadly that he has no money, even though only half month had passed. Great books and manuscript. Manuscript means handwritten books are so expensive, means very costly, that are rare treasure. And exclusive meaning very high quality. But he tells Abdul that not to worry, he will borrow some books from school for his brighter tomorrow. Brighter tomorrow is a phrase means for his better future. Abdul became so happy that he was eagerly waiting for the book. In the evening, when father returned home from school, Abdul asked his father about books. How many books could you get? Oh, now my life will be all set. Father sadly replied, I am so sorry, son. I couldn't bring one book also. Poor Abdul became very sad started thinking very deeply that why my wishes are rejected, continues to do his daily work and reads book in 10 cent scores. Scores means in a 20, sets of 20 books. Then one idea crosses mind that I will serve the rich man and get the paid in kind. Paid in kind means it's a phrase, means payment given in the form of goods and services, not in money. Abdul approaches a rich merchant. Abdul, I am a poor student. Give me a chance to serve. Observe my work. Pay only what I deserve. Merchant, you appear to be smart. Be my clerk. I will pay you well if honestly you work. Some days pass. The merchant calls Abdul. Merchant, I am pleased with your work and loving care. You are indeed a gem, quite rare. I will give you a reward if your demand is fair. Abdul, excited, may I now read the books in your store? Quench my thirst for knowledge. I need nothing more. Chorus. Days passed by. He learned and learned, gaining the knowledge for which he yearned, philosophy, astronomy, Arabic and Persian. Abdul the scholar now is one in a million. Will he come to the emperor's notice? Will he be given an honorable office? Friend, news for you, Abdul. The emperor has answered your prayer. The royal murgi khana is now under your care. Abdul, what? The murgi khana for me, a scholar? Intellectual, sagacious, astute, made a poetry keeper? Never mind. The chance I won't refuse. It's an opportunity. I will put it to good use. Abdul approached the merchant, seeking a chance to serve. He told the merchant to observe his work and then pay what he deserved. The merchant appointed him as a clerk and promised him to pay him well if he works for him honestly. Abdul became very happy. He began to work for merchant. Some days passed. Merchant calls Abdul as he liked his work and loving care. He tells Abdul that he is a rare gem and unique. By hearing this word, Abdul became happy. Then merchant asked Abdul what he wants as reward. Abdul requested to merchant that he need a permission to read all the books from his store. Days passed by. He learned and learned, gaining the knowledge for which he yearned. Yearned means he was waiting for a long time. Philosophy, astronomy, Arabic and Persian. Then Abdul wrote a letter to the emperor, seeking a responsible position in the emperor's court. Will he come to the emperor's notice? Will he be given an honorable office? Few days later, friend brings a news that emperor has answered his prayer. Now the royal murgi khana. Murgi khana is a non-English word for poultry farm. Is under his care. Abdul became disappointed. He thought, murgi khana for me, a scholar, intellectual. Intellectual means intelligent. Sagacious means wise person. Astute means one who knows how to use a situation to his advantage. A poultry keeper. Poultry keeper means a person who looks after chicken. But he said, it's okay. Now it's an opportunity. I won't refuse. He accepted the opportunity and thought, I will make good use of it. It's a phrase, means make good use of something. Chorus. Abdul worked with conviction, zeal and passion. The hens were given a new kind of ration. The birds seemed to be in the pink of health, but nothing was spent from the emperor's wealth. Emperor, how is that? Why are we spending so little on our hens? Have most of them died in the pens? Minister, no, your majesty, they are alive and well. The secret of their health only Abdul can tell. Abdul enters and bows before the emperor. Emperor, how come you spend so little on our hens? How do you nourish them at no expense? Abdul, Jahapana, your humble servant, feeds them well. Food from the royal kitchen, if I may tell, but only scraps and shells and kitchen waste. That's enough for the hens. They relish the taste. It is good for their health. See how they thrive. Waste not, want not. That's my drive. Emperor, interesting young man. You seem to have brains. We put you in charge of the library for all your pains. Chorus, oh no, not again. Only a keeper of books, and he wished to be a courtier. How sad he looks. Abdul, never mind. I love books. I will get down to work. I will handle this well, my duties. I won't shirk. Abdul worked with conviction. Conviction means firm belief. Zeal means enthusiasm, and passion. Passion means love. He got an idea to feed the hens on scrap, shells and with kitchen waste. He spends very little on the hen. The hens relish the taste, grow healthy in the pink of health. Pink of health means fit and fine. The emperor was surprised that very less was spent on the hens. He asked minister if a large number of hens have died in the pens. The minister replied, all hens are alive and well. Abdul only knew the secret of their health. Emperor immediately sent a message to call Abdul. Abdul came and bowed. Bow means respectfully greet in front of the emperor. Emperor asked him how he nourished the hens with no expense at all. Abdul, addressing emperor as Jahapana. Jahapana is a non-English word for emperor. He replied, he fed them well from the royal kitchen, only scraps, shells and kitchen waste. They liked the taste. It was good for their health. Now everyone can see how they now very healthy. He emphasized his philosophy, waste not, want not. Emperor became very happy and impressed with Abdul's work and made him in charge of royal library. After 1 year, the emperor is looking at the books in the library. Emperor, what? All these books have such expensive jackets? Surely they have cost a fortune. Silks, brocades and velvets. Abdul, no, your majesty, the expenses were none. Emperor, I can't believe it. Then how was it done? Abdul, your majesty, I observed that the formal request were sent to you in bags made of the fabric's best. When the papers were read, the bags were discarded. Why waste the silk, velvet, brocade? I demanded. The royal tailors made the jackets. Nothing did they take. Each book was dressed for your majesty's sake. Emperor, you have a great merit. I would realize much earlier. I am happy to announce now you are my courtier. Chorus, wit, brains and perseverance help Abdul achieve his aim. Patience, determination won him great name and fame. Adapted from the story Enter Mulla Do Pyaza by Pratibha Nath. Abdul wants to be a courtier. He became sad to get the position of bookkeeper. Then he thought, never mind, I will not lose my hope. After all, I love books. I can handle my duties very well. I will not shirk. Shirk means avoid my duties. After 1 year, the emperor was surprised to see the books in the library. All the books were covered with expensive cover. He wondered, surely it cost a fortune. It cost a fortune is a phrase. It means cost a lot of money. Brocade. Brocade means a rich fabric woven with golden or silver thread. Silk and velvets. Emperor asked how it was done. Abdul respectfully replied that he observed formal request been sent to emperor in bags made up of best fabrics. When the paper here means official documents, were read, the bags were discarded. Discarded means thrown. Abdul thought, why to waste silk, brocades, velvet? So he requested the royal tailor to make cover with these fabrics. Each books were covered for the royal library. The emperor was so impressed that he immediately appointed Abdul his courtier. Wits, brain and perseverance helped Abdul achieve his aim. Wits means here understanding, brain, intelligence and perseverance means continue to do something in spite of failure helped Abdul to achieve his aim. Achieve his aim is what he wants to be. Patience, determination won him. Patience means to tolerate. Determination means decision to get something, won him great name and fame. Won him to become famous. Name and famous to become famous. Adapted from the story Enter Mulla Do Pyaza by Pratibha Nath. Children, let's see what we have learned from this story. Waste not, want not means that if you do not use too much of something now, you will have some left later when you need it. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful. There are no secrets to success. It is a result of preparation, hard work, and learning from failure. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.